Hello, this is Lee John Hyuk from the New World. In this session, I will explain how to install pyenv on a Mac, and I will also explain how to install pyenv and virtualenv. For your reference, pyenv is a tool that manages Python versions. If you are using multiple versions of Python in your development environment, using pyenv can be very convenient. If you go to this link and scroll down, you will find the installation section. Please click on it. Right now, there is a script here, and we will install pyenv using this script. So please copy it. Please open the terminal, then paste the command you just copied and execute it. After installation, you need to add a script to your bash configuration file. So please click this link in the install section. When you click, you will see options to add to Dash and to G-Shell. Since I use G-Shell, please copy this, paste the script you just copied, run it, and press Enter. Then, you will see that it has been added at the end of my G-Shell. Please close the terminal and run it again. After restarting, run the pyenv version command. If the version is displayed, it means the installation was successful. Next, please type pyenv versions. This will show you the Python versions installed in your environment. Currently, there are no Python versions other than the basic system version. So, let's install a Python version. Type Python install and then hyphen L and press Enter. This will show you the available Python versions for installation. Currently, there is up to 3.14, but I will try installing 3.11.9. pyenv install 3.11.9. The installation is now complete. Next, I will try installing another version. Next, if you enter pyenv versions, it will be displayed like this. In this state, I will set 3.11.9 as the global version. When you run pyenv global 3.71.9 and pyenv versions, it displays the versions like this. If you want to use a specific Python version in a certain directory, you can create a directory with mkdirtemp and then specify that you want to use version 3.10.14 in that folder by entering pyenv local 3.10.14. If I go outside, running Python version will show the global version, but if I enter that folder and run Python version, it will show that version 3.10.14 is being used in that folder. When working on a project with Python, especially for AI projects that require multiple package installations, it's better to create a virtual environment from the start rather than managing different Python versions. For example, for AI Project A, you can have Virtual Environment A, and for AI Project B, Virtual Environment B. This way, you can avoid package conflicts. To set up a virtual environment in pyenv, you can use virtualenv. You can install it in a similar way by clicking here and copying the script. Please paste the copied script and run it. The installation is now complete. In the case of pyenv and virtualenv, you also need to add a script to the bash configuration file. Here, you can see the script. Please copy it. Since I use G-Shell, I will scroll down to the bottom of the G-Shell configuration file. Scroll down to the bottom of the page, and then paste it, and then save it. Please close the terminal window, and then run it again. Now, I will proceed as if I am working on an advanced AI project. Mkdir AI project, CD AI project. Here, we will set up a virtual Python environment. After setting up pyenv virtualenv based on version 3.11, in this specific case, I will call it AI. have successfully created a virtual environment named AI. By entering pyenv versions, you can see the virtual environments I have created. In this state, if I run pyenv local AI, it means that I will be using this AI environment within this folder. So you can install the desired packages using pip and utilize the environment. If you no longer need this environment, you can delete it by running pyenv uninstall AI and confirming with yy. In this session, I explained how to install pyenv, a tool for managing Python versions, and how to set up virtual environments using pyenv and virtualenv. I will definitely see you next time with another topic soon.